Hello everyone, in this video we will discuss about AC to DC rectifier circuit. We use a single phase half wave uncontrolled rectifier and then the output will be purely inductor. Okay, for uncontrolled rectifier we are using normal diode. Okay, we know that inductor. Characteristic inductor is the inductor. They have the characteristic is charging and discharging. Charging process. So during this charging process, the inductor will become current source. So we'll supply current. All right. So let's start. We erase all first. Okay. The function of rectifier is to rectify from the AC voltage to DC signal. So the input is AC. Output will be DC. Okay, the input is sinusoidal. Sine is our input source, sinusoidal wave, Vm sine omega t, and output pulsating, pulse. So this is DC, this voltage. So we split into two parts. So we know that for one cycle we have 0 to 2 pi. So we split first section from 0 to pi and then second section from pi to 2 pi. This we call positive waveform. This is negative waveform or negative cycle. So we start with positive waveform of voltage cycle, which is from 0 to pi. Okay, from 0 to pi. Okay. From 0 to pi, we know that this is a positive waveform. So, like this, the waveform voltage plus and minus. So, current will flow from positive terminal to diode. This is input current. So we know this input diode, the arrow of current and arrow of diode same arrow. Diode like this, current like this. So that means diode will be forward bias. For forward bias diode, this diode will be short circuit. Short circuit forward bias. Then, so current can flow through diode, through inductor, and go back to source, complete one cycle. Okay, we know that when current flow through the diode, through the inductor, what happen? This inductor will be charging. Okay. The charging, the output voltage will be equal to diode voltage L di over dt. Okay, charging will follow the input waveform. So our input will be V out equal to L di over dt. V out equal to L di over dt. Okay, the input, the waveform of the input will be same as the waveform of the output will be same as the input. This is our input. So we know that diode voltage is a short circuit here. So diode voltage 0 volt due to short circuit. So 0 volt. So based on KVL, Kirchhoff voltage law, there is no voltage drop here. Means that all the input will go to the output. So the output will be same as the input from 0 to pi. Okay, the input same as the output same as the input during post cycle. So means that the input is sine omega t, so the output will be Vm sine omega t. Okay, done. So now we let what is I naught? This is V out. What is I out? What is I out? Okay, from this equation, L di over dt equal to Vm sine omega t, we can find the current. So di over dt equal to Vm over L sine omega t. Okay, to find the current, we just integrate both parts. So this integration will become I equal to equal to okay, this is our I current, output current. So if we plot this equation, we can get this kind of waveform from 0 to pi. Okay. Okay, during positive cycle, current flow through inductor. And this inductor will charge. Our inductor will charge from 0, charge until maximum. Okay, at pi, we disconnect, we change the polarity of voltage. The polarity change to, okay, at pi, the polarity of voltage change to negative cycle. So that means we don't supply the current. So this is the maximum of charging of current is equal to Vm over omega L. Okay, at pi. Okay, okay. To now we look at the voltage. Okay, during positive cycle, during 0 to pi, our diode will be switch on or short circuit. Diode short circuit due to forward bias. So we know that for short circuit, our voltage will be 0. So from 0 to pi, diode voltage is 0 due to short circuit. Okay, that's all for positive cycle from 0 to pi. Now we go to a negative cycle, which is from pi to pi. Okay, first we erase. For negative cycle, we start from pi to 2 pi. Okay, negative cycle. Negative input negative voltage. So negative voltage will be negative. negative V max. So plus minus. Okay, before that, previously during positive waveform, we know that current flow here. Current flow through the inductor. So what happened to the inductor? Okay, the characteristic inductor is character will charging. Charging from 0 until pi, it will be charging due to flow of current. So that means that current, it will be charging from 0 to pi, from 0 to pi, it will be charging due to flow of current. So this one is I max here, maximum current flow. Charging here. So then during negative cycle, this inductor will discharge due to there's no supply current there. So that means the inductor will discharge, or we can say that this inductor will become current source. The inductor will become current source. So that means this inductor, this current source will supply current back to source, back to input voltage, and go to surround complete cycle. Okay, this is the arrow of current, the arrow of diode. So same arrow means that this diode will be forward bias, same arrow, or short circuit, forward bias. So this diode become short circuit. Okay, so when diode short circuit, current can flow, complete one cycle. Right. For the output voltage, okay, diode short circuit or diode, so current can allow to flow, means that all the input will go to the output. Same, the waveform of output exactly same as the waveform of input due to current short circuit, diode short circuit. So all the voltage from the input will go to the output, diode short circuit. So same waveform of the input. Okay, the diode short circuit here. So the voltage of diode from pi to pi, 0 volt due to short circuit. 0 volt due to short circuit. And about the current. Okay, we know that this current discharging process. So discharging process means that from maximum it will discharge. So that means the current will be reduced until the minimum. Until 2 pi, this is the minimum amount of current. Then after 2 pi, the cycle will be again alternate to positive cycle. So positive cycle, then current will voltage will input positive form. So the output will be same. The system will be same as the previously. Same as the previous. So it will rotate. It will repeat again and again. So now it will. Sorry. Okay. Okay, the waveform will be continuously continuously. Okay, this is our waveform of the current of the inductor load, single phase half wave and rectifier using inductor load. So now we want to derive the equation. So now we derive our equation for V average. Is equal to, okay, we know that the output is sinusoidal balance, sinusoidal balance. So we have positive cycle, we have negative cycle, we have positive cycle, we have negative cycle. So that means we know that the average is equal to area over time. So we have positive cycle, this area, and this area same. This one is negative area, a positive area, this one is negative. So our average will be equal to zero due to same area, negative and positive area. So zero volt. Okay. I average equal to this. Okay. Next is VRMS. Root mean square. Okay. Again, we know that our output is positive sinusoidal. So this is our output. Sinusoidal, we know that this one is V peak over square root 2 equal to Vm, maximum voltage over square root 2. So this one is for VRMS. Okay, next is the conduction angle. Gamma. Okay, to find the gamma, to find the conduction angle, we have to refer to diode. So waveform of diode. Waveform of diode, so up to what time the diode will be turned on. Okay, when we refer to this diode look like the diode turn on from 0 to pi, from continuously turn on. So this the continuously turn on. Continuously turn on means that this the angle of connection will be all time. Continuously our diode turn on. And this extension angle equal to, we refer to current, the waveform of the current. So from 0 to pi. So 2 pi is our extension angle. Okay. I think that's all for our AC, DC, AC to DC rectifier, single phase, half wave, uncontrolled rectifier, we using inductor load. Analysis of inductor load. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.